Today, I am honored to be able to introduce your class respondent, Alex Izzo. Alex has taken six of my classes, and we've been through a lot. From sophomore year, when we had to deal with a freeware program that made you shoot transistors with a gun, to senior year, when Alex designed a neural network that would predict NCAA tournament results for entertainment purposes only. Alex is a teacher's dream student. He is able to do great work independently and get along with all of the members of our EE family. He's always maintained a positive attitude towards coursework, at least to my face anyway. I did have to overlook the no shorts in lab rule for him more than once, since he apparently needs to be ready to play basketball at a moment's notice. But working in lab with an excellent student like Alex and seeing that challenging problem you knew few students could solve working right there before your eyes is what we engineering professors live for. Yes, we're nerdy. In fact, I'm sure that during more than one lecture, Alex has said to himself, "How on earth can that woman get so excited about VHDL?" Well, I can tell you it's not the VHDL that brings me here to work every day. It's the opportunity to teach students like you, Alex, and your classmates, and be continually amazed at what you're able to accomplish. Alex, it's been wonderful getting to know you, and I wish you all the best in the future. So, ladies and gentlemen, it is my great pleasure to introduce your 2012 class respondent, Alex Izzo.
Good morning, MSOE administration, esteemed faculty, distinguished guests, family, and friends. I'm honored to have the privilege of speaking to you today. First of all, I'd like to congratulate all of my fellow graduates. This is a day we have been looking forward to for a long time. In fact, some of you may want to just stand up and twist and shout with joy. We have all worked incredibly hard to overcome the challenges posed by a tough business, engineering, or nursing curriculum in our academic career. I'm sure there were many moments where we felt like time was standing still, and not just because of the clock in the science building that has set 8:20 for the past 4 years. But now that we sit here today, we can't help but think how fast time has gone by. A large part of the reason that we have made it here is our ability to make good decisions. But that doesn't mean that all of our decisions have been good by any means. I'm sure we've all found ourselves searching for any excuse to avoid studying for an exam the night before we have it, because we don't want to work and we just want to bang on the drum all day. Or sometimes we've had every intention to work hard and our peers convince us to do otherwise. Either way, we've all asked ourselves, should I study for this exam or should I go out to a movie? Should I finish this assignment or should I go out with friends? Should I stay or should I go now? In general, we have made it this far because we have made the responsible decision more often than the irresponsible one. That fact is a testament to our upbringing. So at this time, I'd like to thank my parents and other family members, especially my grandma, who couldn't be here today, but is one of the most inspiring people I know, for always pushing me to do the best that I can. They always made sure I had the eye of the tiger. I encourage all of you to thank your family and friends as well. And don't just say thank you to someone important in your life because they said congratulations. Seek them out and legitimately thank them for all they have done for you. None of us have gotten to this point alone, and any support we received along the way should be recognized. The many excellent professors at MSOE also pushed us to get to this point, even though there were many times where we felt like we were working 8 days a week. They may have challenged us to the point of frustration, but they always had our best interests in mind. We've all been aggravated during office hours when trying to figure out an impossible problem. In fact, one of my friends, Eron, sometimes whips his hair back and forth in frustration. But the professor always calmly said, "We can work it out." I've talked to people from other colleges who have never even met some of their professors, and yet here during my sophomore year, Dr. Raitt, during an 8 a.m. final, not only recognized this exact student who was missing, but also found someone to go wake him up so he wouldn't receive an F on the final. This kind of passion for the student is employed by most of the faculty at MSOE and seems to be unrivaled by faculty at other schools. Accordingly, I'd like to thank all professors, advisors, and other staff who helped us along this journey to our graduation. Undoubtedly, you have set us up for success in the real world. But with this success comes great responsibility. There are many future leaders in this room. potentially leaders in business, technology, and government, among other categories. It is our responsibility to not just make a living for ourselves, but also make the world a better place in doing so. It is crucial for us to give back to the community and provide leadership in any way possible. Over the past few weeks, I've talked to many of my classmates about their feelings toward their experience at MSOE. And whether you can't wait to get out of here or you wish you could spend one more year in college, we've all had some great memories. Hopefully we remember those before we remember the study sessions that were a hard day's night. Hopefully we remember Water Street closing when the Packers won the Super Bowl, or the fact that we experienced two of the four snow days in MSOE history in the past 30 years. Hopefully we remember when we let the good times roll and we forget the times we were taking care of business in the classroom or lab. Regardless of the experiences we remember, the one thing we'll never forget is the friends we made along the way. At one point or another in the past 4 years, we've all needed somebody to lead on, and we've gotten by with a little help from our friends. Without our friends to help us with a homework assignment or provide some stress relief, none of us would be here today. Many times, the friendships forged in college are lifelong friendships. And I hope that my friends here today stay in touch with me in the future. Call me, maybe. Don't just become somebody that I used to know. I will try to do the same in return. It's a weird feeling knowing that 4 years of college have passed, and for many of us, school's out forever. But tonight, we are young. So go celebrate this great accomplishment with those closest to you, and don't forget to thank them for their encouragement and support. Take a break from thinking about school and from stressing out about exams, and just relax. Then, when work starts in a few days or weeks, you can go on, take the money, and run. I would like to thank everyone here for their support towards this fine class of students, and once again like to congratulate all graduates for their outstanding academic accomplishment. Thank you.